are talking to the family members of two of the hottest performers, Billy Ray Cyrus's brother Kevin and Michael Jackson's sister LaToya. They are outsiders from their famous brothers because they are family rebels. My first guest wrote an expose on her family called Growing Up in the Jackson Family. Michael Jackson confirmed the other night on the Oprah Winfrey special what she had said all along, that the Jacksons were abused children. Please welcome LaToya Jackson. Because you said you wanted the belt and the necklace.
Yeah, well, gosh, she goes, here.
Because you had said you wanted it, so I quickly went to my jewel thing and grabbed it out for you.
Well, that's nice of you. Yeah. Thank you very much.
And that worked. Your clothes are fabulous.
This is beautiful. Why, thank you.
Who does them? Who works with
you? Well, I have someone who goes out and shop for me and who basically pick up things for me, but this was made by a guy named Nigel, I think. This
one. It's wonderful.
Thank you.
Did you get a lot of stuff in Paris when you were there?
I try to.
Yeah.
But it's very difficult when you're doing two shows a night and they're 2 hours each and you're there for at least 6 or 7 hours a day. So it makes it very difficult.
Right.
And you don't really get home until about 7 in the morning.
Yeah, yeah.
And so during the day you're doing interviews and basically after that you go right to work. So it's very difficult. But the shops are absolutely wonderful. Yeah. I've done as much as I could possibly do, actually.
Now, let me ask you, do you feel vindicated? You've been saying for the last year and a half, yes, my dad did this, and yes, my family was abused, and everyone's been saying wrong, 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 and suddenly it was right, 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 right. Did you just say, thank God?
Honestly?
Yeah.
No.
What did you feel?
Because I knew what the truth was. I've been knowing it for the longest. I knew it a long time ago, and I was so angry that no one really would speak out. Although no one said it wasn't the truth besides my mother, my father, and one other brother.
Right.
So when he did admit it, it was like, I wish he would have done it sooner. But it was nice that he did, that he was able to admit it. I'm very happy that he did. In that sense, yes.
Did you go into therapy that you were able to come out and say what you said?
I have been working so much ever since this has happened that I really haven't been able to go into therapy, but I have had, I've been twice, actually. She's come to me.
Yeah, well, that's the same thing.
She's come to me. I haven't been able to really go regularly to a class like most people do in a situation such as my situation.
Yeah, yeah.
Which helps a great deal, even though I thought that the book was catharsis for me, but after all that's over, it's like, oh, no, it isn't.
Yeah, because I know when I wrote my book, Ended Talking and Still Talking, both can be bought in paperback or hardcover. But gotta pay the bills. But when I finished my second book, I felt it was a tremendous catharsis.
Yes.
And I really told everything. Did you tell everything in the book, or did you still leave some stuff out?
Joan, I left so much out. That's absolutely nothing. That is basically, I didn't write that book to hurt anyone in the family. I wrote that book because I felt that we should bring awareness to child abuse or any kind of abuse whatsoever. And that's basically why it's written. I didn't go into detail what really happened with everybody in the family. If I would have, I think people would have been just astounded and would have said, there's absolutely no way this could be true.
For example, give me...
Well, I just might be writing a second one, so I can't give you any
but because you talk about sexual abuse with you, and you think your sister was also.
Rebe?
Yeah.
Oh, no, I know she was. We slept in the same bed. She's a lot older than I am, and I was younger than she was, and I was right there when it took place. I was right there.
How old were you when that was going on?
Oh, gosh. Ever since I can remember, what is Rebe? She's 7 years older than I am, I believe it is.
So she was about...
And he was doing that to her, and my mother would sometimes watch.
Your mother would watch?
Sometimes she would watch. Sometimes she would say, no, Joe, not tonight, leave her alone. And sometimes she would stand there and watch him do it.
Why would she allow this?
That's what I want to know, why she would allow it. And that's what I asked my mother when I could no longer deal with it anymore. Because, you know, it gets to a point in your life where you can't deal with this anymore.
Yeah.
Mentally, if you've ever gone through this mentally. And a lot of people don't understand. And they've asked me, why all these years you've come out and now you decide to talk about it? What they don't understand is that it comes to a point in your life where you're constantly thinking about it. I don't know if it's God or whatever it is, but somebody keeps telling you, this isn't right. You got to talk about it. You got to bring it out in the open. You must talk about it. Everything I did, that's all I would think about it constantly. And I kept saying, Mother, I need help. And she would say, I can't help you. I said, but Mother, I keep thinking about it every single day. You have to help me. Why did he do those things to me? Why did he do that to her? Why did he do those things? And she says, if you ever mention this, I will never speak to you again, and I will tell everybody that you're a liar and that you're crazy and no one will ever believe you.
And that's what happened.
And that's what she did.
And now
she told me that I should keep it silent. This is something that belongs in the family and no one should know about it.
Yeah.
And I approached her again. I said, but you don't understand. I said, mentally it's eating me apart. I want to know why. Why did he do this? And that's when she would continue to say that to me.
How old were you when you finally left home, when you said enough?
Oh, gosh. I left home when I was 29.
That's a, why did you stay so long?
I had my 29th birthday.
Did it cripple you the other way? Do you know what I mean?
When you're from a dysfunctional family, such as my family, and things of this sort happens, you don't really realize what's really going on because you're caught up into that web. And even though I've made several attempts to leave home, I was never really able to do it. My parents would stop me. My father would say, I don't care where you are, I'm gonna find you and come back and drag you right back home.
Right.
And at the same time, my mother was my best friend then, and she would say to me, Latoya, it's not right for you to be out there on your own. You're a girl, you can get kidnapped, anything could happen to you, guys will follow you, and it's not a safe world for you to be out there. So all these things are going through your mind, not knowing at the time they're working together.
Right.
Because they're your parents.
Did you talk about your mother in the book, watching and all that? Was that substantiated in the book?
No.
No.
That's not in the book, no. Again, I didn't want to hurt anybody. But now I feel better, now that I get to speak openly about it, simply because my mother is denying it. I had no idea. I thought maybe if I just brought it out into the open, and she stopped condoning this abuse, and I felt that once I brought it out, she would say, well, maybe I should say this is something we've done wrong, and we could probably try to rectify this by admitting it. But
she
hasn't.
Was frightened of your father? I mean,
no,
for a mother to stand by.
She wasn't. You know, at some point in your life, you think, well, gosh, well, maybe she was. But she was not. My mother manipulated everything that went on. She manipulated everything. When you really think about it and you go back, especially when you go to psychiatrists, they really dig things out. And but I knew that prior to that, that she was the one who was manipulating everything.
What I want to do is go to commercial. I want to talk about how you got yourself, how you even dated, how you got, you know, how you pulled yourself out to the point that you pulled yourself out. We'll be back with Latoya Jackson in a moment, so please stay tuned. We are talking about family rebels. Your parents have denied all this. Your parents, your father, obviously, your mother's denied ever knowing about it, ever standing there, ever, you know. And now Michael just came out and denied about plastic surgery. What, you know, he said he only had two plastic surgeries or something like that, I think, on Oprah. Why? What is, what's, go, why? Do you know what I'm saying? I don't understand.
I don't know why, but I must tell you this, Joan. When Michael said he's had two plastic surgery, he was telling the truth. He's had his nose done and a cleft put in his chin, but he's had his nose done so many times that...
So in other words, it's the truth, but it's not the truth.
Right. In other words, when he said two, he meant two things done.
Right.
That's probably how I should phrase it.
Okay. All right.
But he's had his nose done several times.
Because in our business, who cares? You know, in our business...
Right, who cares? That we know that everybody in Hollywood...
Everybody.
Like, wasn't that wonderful what he said about the people in Hollywood?
What did he say? I missed that... What did he say?
He said that if everyone in Hollywood or in show business decided to go on vacation who's all had plastic surgery, there would be no one left.
Yeah, well, I always say if I had a stitch for every, if I had a nickel for every stitch in everybody's head in Hollywood, I could retire tomorrow, which is the same thing. But that's, has the whole family had it done?
Their nose?
Oh, just in general, anything.
Well, if my family had anything done, it would be their nose, definitely.
Did everybody do it?
Not to my knowledge, no.
No.
But then I haven't been home in a long time, so.
How does that feel, not be? It was such a, was it a close family, or am I just assuming?
No, it was a very, very close family.
Because big doesn't always mean close.
We had each other.
Yeah.
We had each other. It was very close. But I think families start really tearing apart. I don't know why this happens, but it does every time. When people start marrying off.
Well, other influences come in.
other influences and they start branching off, and that's basically what happens, and then you start dividing like that.
What about you, which we were talking about? You got married late.
Yes,
why?
I did.
Why? You must have had a million, you must have been in love 35 times before you left home.
No.
Did you not get a chance to meet, or what?
No, my parents were strict, I was religious, and that didn't interest me. And my mother is my best friend, and she always told me that if she didn't have me, she didn't know what she would do, she would die. And so I stayed at home, Joan, like an idiot, every single day. I lived my life for my mother, for no one else but for my mother. And my brothers would always comment, if mother died, you would commit suicide the next day, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
And I would say, yes, but I wouldn't do it today, no way.
So what happened from that closeness to now, it must rip you.
It's just the opposite.
All over the
place. As much as we shared that closeness, which I thought was closeness, but really wasn't. It was her way of keeping me with her and keeping me down, because that's what she wanted. Because when I left with my manager, which in fact my mother and my father appointed him to be my manager because Jack Gordon was working for my family at that particular time. However, my parents, of course, refused to believe that he was Jewish. And they insist on believing the fact that he was Italian, which in fact he was not Italian, he was Jewish.
And what would that mean?
Well, my mother's anti-Semitic and my sister Janet, of course, is anti-Semitic as well. And they didn't like the fact that he was Jewish.
Was this talked about in your book?
Yes, that's in my book
that
as well.
That is in your book.
Yes.
What?
They didn't like that. And basically, when he decided to go on, and he took me on to manage, and they gave him the management,
right.
And we went away, and he did a wonderful job. They didn't like it. They felt that we could have done that, even though they didn't do anything. So my mother said, I will do everything in my power to stop your career, make sure you get nowhere, and you'll never be known, and I will make sure that this happens no matter what.
Because he was Jewish?
Because of that, and because I was with him, and he was Jewish. And she didn't want to see me make it. She wanted me right there with her.
Now, how did you leave the house? It was a big fight, right?
Yes, there was a big fight. But it wasn't with me. It was with my manager and my father and my mother, of course.
Now, how was it to get married? Nobody came to the wedding?
Well, it wasn't a planned wedding. I didn't know I was getting married.
Yeah, but when you got... But, I mean, it must...
I didn't know I was getting married, so it wasn't planned.
But what about holidays? What about all that? Do you know what I'm saying?
Well, we never really celebrated holidays because of our religion at that particular time.
Which was?
Jehovah's Witness. So it never meant anything to us, actually.
Christmas doesn't mean anything, or?
Believe it or not, I celebrated my first Christmas, this Christmas. And it was quite different for me, but I loved it.
Yeah.
The spirit was great.
So have you gone away from being Jehovah's Witness out, or?
Well, I'm not a Jehovah's Witness, no. I'm definitely not a Jehovah's Witness. After the pictorials, I'm sure that they've disfellowshipped me, though they've never come to me and told me that, but I'm sure.
What about your childhood? Michael came out and said he had a miserable childhood. He was crying. And I thought while I was watching that, well, you can't have, if there are that many kids in the family, you should have friends within the family. You know?
Do, and you have one another, and he mentioned that. You have one another, and you love one another, and you play with one another, and we're constantly telling each other we love each other because that's all we had. However, it's so miserable because your parents are not nice, and you lean towards the nicer parent, which,
right.
In fact, in that our case, of course, was my mother.
Right.
And you lean towards that, but it can be very miserable. And I've always said, when I would go out and I would speak, I would always say that a lot of people think that we lived a wonderful life and we had everything we wanted, which in fact, of course, we did. But we were very unhappy. When everybody in the family at one point or another tries to commit suicide, something's wrong. We were very
everybody
unhappy.
Everybody tried to commit?
At one point or another, yes.
Did you?
Yes. Yes, I did.
And what stopped you?
Michael. And my manager once,
yeah.
And it's all because of my father.
And have you come to peace with that now?
With what exactly?
With the abuse, the childhood, the mother now turning out to not be what you thought. I mean, that's a lot to have to live through, to wade through.
And it's a lot just for me. Because when I was told this is sort of like straying away. When I was told that I would be kidnapped, I laughed. I said, they're my parents. Why would they do a thing like that?
They told you.
And I would laugh about it. I go, that's crazy. They're my parents. They could never do a thing like that. And I didn't believe it. So I can understand when I came out with my book and I started talking about the issues and things that happened in my family, when the public didn't believe it, I could understand that. Because there are certain things I didn't believe because they were so deceiving.
If you could, you haven't spoken to your parents for how long now?
Well, it's been a year, but I haven't really spoken because my mother loves to get on television and say, LaToya, we love you, please call home and come home and the whole bit. And I call and I go, Mother, hi, it's LaToya. Click, I don't want to talk to you. She hangs the phone up. So it's that same act that keeps going on and on. And I wish they would stop that act because this was not a fairy tale life. They want the public to think that the Jackson Five and the Jacksons were this wonderful, loving family that grew up together. And we were not like that. We were not that perfect image that the record company wanted us to be. And I'm not saying this just to destroy the family, but I'm saying this to let people know that that doesn't exist. And we had a lot of hard times in our family. We really did, emotionally.
Do you think that's why Michael can't connect emotionally with someone?
I think it has a lot to do with it.
Because that you can means you're so healthy that you can make any kind of a commitment to someone, that you can trust anybody.
We were painfully shy. There were so many things wrong with us that we didn't really realize it. Because we thought it was normal, because when you live like that and your parents keep you so secluded from the rest of the world, you think these things are normal. And they're not. And not until you walk out into the outside world, you realize, gosh, I'm so different.
Yeah.
And you look at people and you go, gosh. Because even with the religion teaches you to stay in that realm and don't associate with anyone outside the religion.
Right.
So there again, you're secluded again and you're sheltered by that.
What about your life now? Where do you see it going? Where do you want to be? It's a sentence too. Where would you, like in 10 years, I'd like to be like the oldest woman alive, still asking questions. And they'd say, she asked the same question twice,
like
but let her do
pictures.
It, you know.
No, I like to do motion pictures. That's what I really like to do, yes.
Has that started?
Yes. Yeah, sort of. I've done a bit while I was in Paris, and I'm working on an exercise video now at the moment. And
what about family? Would you dare to have children? Would you want to have children? Do you think you could cope with it?
Yes, I'd like to adopt more than anything else. I feel that there are so many kids out there that need love that I could adopt them.
Let's go to commercial. We'll come back. We'll talk some
sure.
more. We'll be right back with more in a moment. Please stay tuned. And of course, LaToya Jackson. And later on in the show, we're going to meet Billy Ray Cyrus' brother Kevin. You know, we've asked your parents to come on several occasions. Even I think today the court was made. So whatever you're saying now, they could have been here to refute it. And
yes.
God knows they've been given the opportunity. What do you do? First of all, what are you doing now? Because you look so great. Let me just even get to that before we even go back to talking about other things.
Well, I'm working on an exercise video.
Right.
That's what I'm doing now, even though I haven't started working out yet.
But if that's not working out, you look great.
I'll start next week.
Right.
And I'm also doing on March 1st a pay-per-view that's called LaToya Exotic Club Tours. And basically what it is, it's that I go to exotic places all over the world and I take the people there. And it's on pay-per-view. And it's wonderful, beautiful places with beautiful girls. It's not like a concert or anything like
right,
that because
right.
people think that's what it is.
What about the money? Do the Jacksons... The Jacksons, not did they, made millions and millions and millions and millions. Did you get your share of that?
No, I did not.
How can they not if you deserve it? I mean, shouldn't the pie be divided up? You're over 21.
No, not really. You have to remember the Jackson Five were the Jackson Five. They made that money. LaToya didn't make it. I don't deserve any of it. And I wouldn't want anything that I didn't deserve.
But do people expect you to live like a Jackson, which means, I know you're doing very, very well, but... I mean, you think of Jackson,
but
you just think
years.
Millions. You could have your own amusement park. You can have anything you want. You know, you're thinking millions.
Right, that was the Jackson Five. Then later, as the Jacksons, the girls joined the group.
Right, and that was different.
That was different, yes.
That was
different, but that's not where my money came from, though. Because during that particular time, my father just pushed me into show business, and he's the kind of father that you don't say no to or anything like that. And money was not an issue. It was never brought up. It was nothing that I ever needed because we had everything at home. Right. But my money basically came through writing songs. I've written a lot of number one records for other artists.
All over
the country, all over the world. Jimmy Cliff, Reggae Nights. A lot of people don't know that I wrote that. It outdid Michael's Thriller, actually, over in Europe. I've written several songs for him that have reached number one.
So that's great.
Yeah, and you believe it or not, you get so much from that.
See, now there's so many stories that we don't know. What are some of the rumors that you just want to dispel?
Well, there's one rumor that I'd like to speak about is the rumor that happened in Vegas. A lot of people got the impression that I was thrown out of Vegas and I didn't get along with the guy or whatever at the Sands Hotel, but it had nothing to do with the hotel. It was a contract with the producer of a show, Insight, which you know how that works, of course. And he wasn't able to pay me. And he didn't tell me that he wasn't going to pay me. And he couldn't even pay his own staff. And he did pay me with a bad check. So I decided I'm not going to work here any longer. And I decided to leave. And before I knew it, before I could get back to New York from Vegas, it was all over the papers. It was all over the news. Vegas kicks LaToya out. They boot her out. But they did not pay me. And who's going to work for free? Would you work and still have? Would you work for free?
Are you kidding? Let's go.
Two shows a night. I mean, really, she knows what Vegas is like. Two shows a night, and sometimes you really don't feel up to doing it, and you got to really smile for the public and the whole bit, and he's not paying you on top of that, and you work a whole week free, and then the second week comes, and it's like forget it.
Now I'm sitting here looking at you and talking to you, and I'm looking for the skin disease. Now what is that? explain this to me.
Explain it to you?
Explain it to me.
Honestly?
Did you know that this ran in the family?
I have no recollection of any type of... I'm not saying that he's not telling the truth, but I have never heard of a skin disorder in our family. I've seen this disease before.
Oh, I have too.
On other people, it's fine, but I look the other way because I'm the kind of person that I think if you look at something long enough, you may get it.
Yeah.
And I would always look the other way. And I would say, oh my God, and I'd look the other way out of embarrassment, of course, for them and then for myself as well. Like, right. I don't want to get this, but no, I've never known that to run in our family, no.
Okay, just curious. Now, while we're just getting rid of rumors here, what about Donald Trump? Because Donald claims that you pursued him.
He claims I pursued him.
Didn't we have him on the show? And didn't Donald say we pursued him?
I would never.
Not we pursued him, you pursued him.
I would never ever pursue Donald. I think what Donald has always been very, very nice to me.
He's a nice man, really.
He's a very nice man, don't get me wrong. He's a very nice man, he's always been nice. He's always called me up, he's always asked me, would you like something? Would you like to go to dinner? What are you doing tonight? And the whole bit. And I've always been very polite to him and said, well, that's very kind of you. Thank you very much. But I think I'm going to stay home and read a book. And I've always said things like this to him because I didn't go out. I didn't date. I didn't do those things. And I think because of that, it got out in the tabloids, not through me, but through someone else. It got out in the tabloids, and Donald doesn't like the fact that he was rejected, and the public knows about it. He has an ego. So because of that, this man comes on television, he comes in the tabloids, and he says such terrible things about me. And I'm in total shock, like, this is the nice guy that would always call me and talk to me. I have never called him. He calls me all the time, and I would never go out with him, and that's what it is.
Why do the tabloids treat you so badly? I think they're very unfair to you. I think
they're
just
unfair to a lot of people.
Yeah. Oh, I know that.
Not just me, but to a lot of people.
Look who you're talking to. But but why do they, certain people are their darlings?
And certain people they like to talk about.
Yeah.
You know, there's one award that I always know I'm going to get every year, and it's always the worst dress. Why?
Worst
I don't
dress.
Know. But it's funny because in Europe, I always get the best dress award.
So you just had to balance.
And I always get this every year, whether it's in People or it's with the other guy. I can't think of his name, but you know that guy.
Blackwell.
Yes, Blackwell. I don't know why they do this to me, but they just... Let's pick on LaToya. That's who we'll pick on. Yeah, we'll get LaToya.
The name and the glamour, and it's easy...
They target me. I don't know why.
What about your family? Back to that again. You know, we have this... we're coming down to the close of the interview. If your family's watching, I'm sure they're watching. Because if you could look in the camera, what would you... say to your family? I'm going to say, if they want to come on, please come on. If they, you know, whatever you've said. And as I said, we've asked them to come on. But what would you say if you could talk to your parents after a year?
My siblings, that's no problem. They all know.
What would you say to your
siblings? Well, they know that I love them and they love me. So that's.
You don't talk to any of them?
Yes, we do. We speak.
Do talk.
Yes.
Who do you talk to?
I'd speak to my brothers and my sisters, Michael, yes.
All of them?
Yes. I haven't, well, the last time I spoke to Janet, it wasn't quite so pleasant, so that's kind of, she was kind of upset by the anti-Semitic remark that she constantly makes all the time.
Right.
And she said, why would you put it in your book? I said, because I'm trying to teach you. You can't, you know, if you want to preach about love and forgiveness, you got to start somewhere.
Yeah.
And this is what I wanted to get straight with her, because I was always so afraid, because she would always say, here comes that bastard Jew, meaning my manager at the time. And I was always afraid that he would hear her one day.
Did he?
And he heard her one day. And he says, why didn't you tell me Janet was prejudiced? And I didn't know what to say. I was speechless. And I would always say, he's going to catch you one day saying that. And he did. And he caught her saying it. And it hurt, because I didn't want him to know she felt that way. But she would always ask him for financial help. Like, can you help me invest this, or can you do this for me? But she would say that behind his back. I'll use him, but I don't want to have anything to do with him because he's Jewish.
Yeah. What about your parents? What would you say if you, because I'm sure they're watching.
Just to be very open about the situation and just admit to the fact that you were abusive and you've done something wrong, and stop condoning it, because you're hurting a lot of innocent children who are out there who could bring this open and bring it out and make them more aware of it. And the longer you deny it, the worse you're making it for a lot of young kids out there who are suffering and who thinks that it's okay to keep this hidden and keep it within, and it's not okay.
Gee, I just think you're terrific. I'm so glad you came on.
Why, thank you.
Just a pleasure. Please
thank
come
you
back.
For having
just
me.
Just a pleasure
having me.
And we'll be right back to find out why Billy Ray Cyrus's brother broke his heart. Okay.
Until she walked out of my door. Too little, too late to say I'm sorry. 'Cause she's not crying anymore. She's not crying.